Today, we're diving deep into Shopify's game-changing AI tools that are revolutionizing how online stores operate. So whether you're just starting out or you're running actually an established brand, all these tools that they've enabled can actually help you save time and boost sales significantly. So let's talk about Shopify magic. It's like having a whole team of experts literally at your fingertips. This isn't just another feature. It's a sort of a collection of AI power tools sprinkled throughout Shopify. And they can handle everything from product descriptions to customer service. So first up, let's look at the product description generator, right? Imagine having perfect SEO optimized descriptions for hundreds of products in minutes instead of hours or potentially even days, right? So here's how it works. You want to open up your products, and in here, I already have a product description. So this is more for an established, this example is for an established store, right? I have something written up in here. Maybe you're purchasing items from vendors and they give you some form of description. You can technically paste that description right here within this product description section. And then what you can do is actually you can highlight it and click on the stars. It's gonna be the purple stars, right? Anytime that you see these purple stars anywhere on your store, just know that you have Shopify magic backing you up. So if you want to rephrase this, for example, or extend it or simplify it, you can do so by just clicking a button. Now, for this one in particular, I want to rephrase it. And then it gives you the option to also choose the tone. So if you want expert, daring, playful, sophisticated, persuasive. So let's try persuasive, and then let's click generate again. Experience the passion and quality of the I Would Die For You vintage distressed tea. This 1980s inspired unisex t-shirt is made from a premium blend of 100%. So there you go. It gives you kind of like a more of a paragraph style, right? Than compared to what we had before, which is like the bullet points. I think both would be beneficial to have when it comes to a product description. I think product descriptions, it's good to have this paragraph, right? This initial paragraph to start your product description, but then going into maybe some of the product details, you could also use product meta fields to then expand into maybe certain drop downs within your product. So you have your main product description, which is maybe just all the written text, paragraph form. And then you can have a product details where it just breaks it down into maybe more bullet points. It also gives you some additional instructions that you can set up in here. So if you have any emojis or maybe keep the bullet points or add the bullet points towards the end of the prompt, you can do so by giving it a special instruction right within here. Hey everyone, I'm Christian, one of the co-founders here at Bit Branding. We specialize in helping clothing brands scale online. We've served over 300 clothing brands in the last year alone. Quick favor from you, if you hit that like and subscribe button in the next 3 seconds, I will share with you towards the end of this video, Sidekick. Get ready for that. Next up is actually one of my favorite features, and this is the AI image editor. With it, you can do a bunch of different things like remove backgrounds instantly. You can add professional backgrounds. You can resize images. You can create some of that consistent product imagery. This is something that we talk about a lot in the channel when it comes to websites having that look and feel that, you know, makes you a little bit more trustworthy for customers coming in here. Having that consistency with your imagery is super, super important. So some brands, right, if you're buying from a bunch of different vendors, you're going to get imagery from your brands or your vendors that are going to be slightly different one from the other. So in order to combat that and make them all a little bit more consistent, what you could do is if you have just a kind of like the plain, you know, plain t-shirt on maybe like a simple background, you could remove all those backgrounds and have that consistency throughout your website. So let me just show you an example here on how something like that would look. So this is a great example. This is a simple background, technically, right? We have a model just wearing a shirt and some white pants. And at the end of the day, this is good, right? But maybe your next vendor has a true just white background, right? This has kind of like a slight grayish background to it. So it's not quite just, you know, clear white background. So what we can do here is we can click on color background. So again, anytime that you see that purple tone, that means that you're using Shopify magic or AI in the back end to make some changes here. So as you can see, this color bucket, the color background has the purple, and then the replace background also has purple attached to it. So with this, you can actually change it to just a no background. So just a kind of transparent PNG. You could do plain white. If you have black in your store, you can do black or literally any other custom color that you would like. You could also do replace the background. So if you wanted this model to be somewhere, right? So we have to describe what we were looking at here. So man wearing t-shirt, and describe the background that you want. So maybe we can do like a professional studio. Let me see how, because what we had before was kind of like a professional studio, but professional studio with maybe cameras in the background. Okay, so here we have some examples. And again, like this is probably not something that we would do, but it, maybe you kind of want this aesthetic, right? Of something looking maybe a little bit more raw and whatever. So there you have it. They have some lights, some cameras in the background. They also give you suggestions, right? On maybe some things that you could use as backgrounds, like kitchen, bathroom, city, jungle, beach, studio. This is kind of like more what I was looking for. So the more detailed that you can be with your descriptions, the more sort of like imagery you can convey within your words, the better the prompt is going to end up. And again, think about this. These are free tools, right, that Shopify has given us. But to me, like just the ability to change that color background to just like the plain white or transparent background, it's super, super powerful for all of our store owners. So highly recommend for you to check that out. Now, next up is customer service. And customer service is pretty cool because you can get 24/7 literally automated responses to some of the most frequently asked questions. You can almost set up a person who's just monitoring everything here in the back end. It knows policies, it knows your products, and it can give personalized recommendations to your customers. So if you go to, or if you don't have it yet, I would suggest to install Shopify Inbox. So Shopify Inbox is going to be the instant chat solution for Shopify. It's made by Shopify, so it's a free app. But when you install it in your store, just know that it won't be under your apps, but it will be under your sales channels. So they consider Inbox as part of your sales channel. Back in the day, you could connect it with a bunch of your other platforms, but now you can't do that anymore. But it gives you a few things you can do here. So from the get-go on the overview tab here, you'll see like the get more out of your inbox. And again, you'll see that purple. So that means Shopify Magic is in here. So what you can do is you can manage instant answers. So by default, this is just a test store. So we don't have a whole lot in here that's necessarily relevant or like cohesive, right, within the same brand. So it may have some problems like capturing exactly what our brand is all about. But at a glance, it looks like it got our return policy in here. So you see that again, the purple stars in here. So if you click on it, this is a suggestion from Shopify Magic. It looks like the question is, what is your return policy? And the answer is, we accept returns within 14 days of delivery. So it basically went through our return policy that we have set up in the back end and created this just short version of it, summarized version of it. And what you can do is you can turn that particular question on. So this will now show up as part of like the instant answer. So when a customer clicks on to chat with you, they'll have the opportunity to write a message for you, but they can also see some of the instant answers or like frequently asked questions, if you will, and it will take care automatically of answering that via the message that you have in here. So if the tone of voice or something here needs to change just slightly, you can just retype a little bit in here. Hey, before we move on, I just want to say, if you're a clothing brand owner watching this and you want to dive deeper into growing your brand profitably online, I got something special for you. We're offering a free 45-minute strategy session, but spots are going to be limited. So I want you to click in the description below to secure your spot before they are gone. Again, free 45-minute strategy session. So next up is email integration. The AI marketing email tools are gonna help you create compelling subject lines. You can create personalized email content, schedule the optimal times, track, analyze results. So again, just like Shopify Inbox, Shopify Email is an app that you have to install in your Shopify. I think by default, they may already have it pre-installed for you, but just know that, again, it's a free app, it's made by Shopify, and it's just a way for them to give you more features, right? But not give you everything out of the gate. They want you to kind of be a little bit more invested, right? And kind of download that app in order to get those features. But again, completely free. But here we have an example of just an email in here. And I wanted just to show you some of the things that you can do with Shopify Magic. So one, it's gonna be subject lines, right? So for this particular subject line, I think we have absolutely nothing in here written. So what we can do is we can generate text. So describe what this email is about. This is a welcome discount and has bestsellers, and we want the tone to be persuasive. So there at a glance, it gives us three different options for our subject line. So we can do discover top picks now. And then the preview line doesn't give us it doesn't give you the option to do. So it's just a subject line really that gives us the option to generate that text. And then the other placement for this is going to be any type of content, written content that you have here on the email. You can also generate that content, right? Describe exactly what you want, the tone, if you want special instructions, and then hit generate. So this will be particularly great when you're building out your automations. All these automations, like the welcome series, or if it's like an abandoned cart or abandoned browse, like win back series, all these types of email series that you should have set up in the back end are going to be very easy to write the content for by using the generate content through here. Just a little tidbit for you here as well. Shopify email, they've actually been just adding new things in here. One of those new things is a countdown section. So now you can actually have a true countdown module within your email. So if you have some kind of sale going on and there's a true end date to your sale, you can actually put that section right here within that particular email, which is pretty cool. Now for something that it's absolutely mind-blowing and it's going to absolutely help a bunch of Shopify store owners, this is gonna be Sidekick. So they've decided to, I mean, everything else throughout Shopify is called Shopify Magic, but they have now this chatbot that helps you answer questions and also complete tasks in the backend for you, which is, again, just mind-blowing. Even for myself, I'm like, this is really awesome. So the name of it is Sidekick. Some people still don't have this fully enabled. So that's you. It's coming soon. More than likely, it'll be this year where it's sort of fully rolled out to everybody. But if you do have it, you will see the little masked guy here in the top corner and you click on it and then this chat view pops in. By default, it gives you some examples of some things that it can do for you. But again, it's more than just answering questions. It can actually do things for you. So let's just go with like the doing, because I think that's one of the most exciting parts of this. So as an example here, it's like list customers from the past 90 days. You can just click on that. And then it says, sure, let's create a segment for customers who have been added in the past 90 days. Because it's a Play Store, we have one customer in that list. So it didn't take very long to generate that list. And then we can click on preview and it will take us directly to where we need to go. And as you can see now, there's this new segment that's created. It's on draft and it's added the code, right? It's not code, but it's just like the way that they generate these segments or these reports. So speaking of reports, that's also another placement. Let me look at analytics reports. I'm just curious if I have, okay, yeah. So this store is not enabled, the new reports, but Shopify just released pretty much like reports 2.0. And in those reports, obviously these reports that we have here, these are like the ones that Shopify gives you, but now you have the ability to create and generate your own reports. And you can use Shopify Sidekick to basically tell it like, I want to create a report that only shows me Canada customers in the past 90 days who have purchased hats and they have used a discount, right? Like you can just type in all that stuff and it will give you all the information to generate that report automatically in the backend, which is brilliant and I love it. But yeah, for this store that we have here, we don't have it enabled, but if you do have it enabled, when you go to analytics and you go to reports, you should see here at the top right button, they name it something different, but it will be a button in here to sort of like add your new report or add a custom report in there for you. Okay, so yeah, this was awesome. Let's go back to some of the recommended or sort of like a new thread or conversation here. You can also create a collection. So create a collection for low stock products. Let's just click on that real quick. And just know that these are just examples. Like you can literally make your own prompt and try to make it do certain tasks for you. So low stock title of the collection is low inventory. This collection features products that are currently low in stock. It's a smart collection. There's one rule. It even creates the SEO title, SEO description. Let's click on preview. And the beauty of it is that, yeah, it takes you directly to where you need to go. Inventory stock is less than 10. And again, you can change that parameter if it doesn't work necessarily for you. But again, super easy to do, literally just a click of two buttons I clicked and I was able to create a collection and have all this stuff written right within here. And then obviously the other thing is like, you know, how do I do like a test order, for example? Like some of these things are gonna be more instructional, but it will still be able to give you the instructions. And sometimes it even tells you just kind of like this, where it tells you exactly, do you want me to take you there basically? And it's absolutely amazing. This is, to me, better than the Shopify help docs. Obviously it's pulling data from there, but this just makes it so much easier because within those help docs, sometimes there's way too much information or way too many things included within there. You still have to figure out, you know, what it is that you need from that. But as you can see here, it just breaks it down beautifully for you. It just looks nice. And then like I said, yeah, towards the end here, I guess this takes you directly to the help center just for some additional information. So, and these are the ones that just have sometimes more information that you need. But if you do need that, then it still takes you over there. And then these are, yeah, this is what I was talking about too. Let me save that. Because this will take us, yeah, directly to where we need to go. So again, it just makes things so much easier. And I'm so excited about Sidekick and I'm excited for Sidekick to roll out to all of our members and for you as well that are watching, because it's gonna help you tremendously. Obviously, we've implemented a lot of these tools and we use Shopify Magic and Shopify Sidekick for a lot of our customers. And it can reduce time that you spend on building your site, on figuring out text for emails, descriptions, right? In essence, this will make you sell products faster because it's enabling you to even have almost like 2, 3, 4 different people, right, in the back end, sort of like working for you and helping you figure things out. So it's a huge, huge time saver. So action plan. Start with the product descriptions, implement the image optimization, and set up your email automations through Shopify email, and use Shopify Magic to generate all this text. And as a bonus, if you have Sidekick enabled, use it. Use it now. All right, we'll see you in the next one.